sports. It's in the game.
You be in your zone when you winning on your own. When you winning, wake up, look out the window, see the rose in the Bentley. When you winning, when you winning, when you winning, all you ride designer clothes. When you winning, keep when you winning. People all in your business, gotta ride with it. Tell me when you winning, when you winning, when you winning. Yo, she could come around but can't stick around. That's how I tease her. Been having my way since a little. Be no pleaser. Always gonna crush these souls when they realize I don't need them. I don't give a fuck how close wheels. You cross the line, I'm squeezing. Every day the same routine, same, ain't no new team. Never ever had hoop dreams, but I'm
about. We're at the home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Tonight, we've got a good NFC matchup in store, as it'll be the New Orleans Saints taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. On play action, it's Carr. He'll buy some time right. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
And that's an early scramble that can be viewed positively by either side. From the offensive point of view, it begins to establish him as a possibility to keep it on certain plays. And defensively, they avoided giving up a huge play in one of their first tests in containing a quarterback on the run.
Here's Carr to throw. Oh, his first throw of the game.
We got London on the
whole club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I keep it too real for real, and that's that made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich.
Whole club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my radius. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. The whole club. White to be shooting in the eyes. I'm sleeping good at night. See the door don't got no locks. So these spikes, well, she best friends with the ops. And that you need better stocks. Standing on my money, dog. Please don't get involved. Ain't nobody running off. Rules to the basics. I can't be no son-in-law. I can't take the summer off. I make it look good and all, but this is no vacation. All the goons, they respect me and I know it. Watch your words and your tone, you're not a poet. My advice, please don't try to be wrong. Let me know they
whole club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Gold diggers don't come around, they don't survive my radius. I
keep it too real for real, and that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich.
And whole club selling out of here to doing stadiums. Small business don't come around, they don't survive my ratings. All I talk about, and that's what really made me rich. Hustling, that's what made me rich. That's what made me rich.
The never had club. A mentor. I only watched Scarface. I met her at a club. She twerked better when her heart break.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we are in the Steel City at Pittsburgh's Acrisure Stadium. Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here, as it'll be the Philadelphia Eagles taking on their in-state rivals to the west, the Pittsburgh Steelers. It's an old-school battle in the Keystone State of Pennsylvania. The Eagles and the Steelers are underway. Austin elects to bring this out of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. To throw it here. And that nearly an interception here on this opening drive, but he gets a reprieve. It's third down.
I like the calmness of how he played the ball here. No panic in his eyes as that throw arrived. Tracked it from the moment it left the quarterback's hand, and that's just where he needed to be to knock it away.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Connect, incomplete. I'll give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
You get a sense of what this game plan might be. They think they can take a few home run shots against this defense. They tried it there on the opening drive, but that ball's incomplete.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Fielded at about the 28. 54 yards on the punt there, 15 on the return. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. Now Hurts changing up the play. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Brown. The result, only 4 yards there on the play, and it's second down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
And I think he was a little surprised to see the ball sitting out there like that. That's a ball he had a chance to come away with, but it winds up an incomplete pass.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and 6. Here's Hurts to throw. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Eagles.
play action. Here's Hurts. And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Quez Watkins, 36 yards. And the Eagles get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Both sides of the football in sync early. You force the three and out, and then you take it down, score points.
You know what that tells me? They sold their game plan really well. Head coach said, listen, we're just going to stop them on three and out. We're going to take the ball downfield and score. But he also told them how it was going to happen. They're going to run this. We're going to stuff it. Then we're going to take the ball. They won't be able to keep up with us. And they got it done.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Austin elects to bring this out of the end zone. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive.
And on the first drive, three and out. I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day.
Anomaly. I'm an organic organism, ain't no ordinary organs in them. I can't afford any synonymy. That's why my flow is like a cinnamon tsunami with the lemongrass. Ooh, ooh, let me know what you wanna do. If you wanna build, I'm Bobby. If not, then kick it in the lobby. I got a lot to do. Ooh, I'ma watch what you gonna do. If you gonna build, I'm Bobby. If not, then chuck a deuce. Dairy in my diary. I'm from a lactose intolerance community. I want to circulate the units in the unity, the continuity of opportunity for stacking bands, opportunity to stack the figures with your family. I can show you how to get the figures in advance. I don't see nobody else but us giving a damn. Ooh, ooh. So let me know what you want to do. If you want to build, I'm Bobby. If not, sucker, kick it in the lobby. I got a lot to do.
We are at the home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Coming up, we got a good matchup on tap here, as it'll be the Baltimore Ravens taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. Play action with Jackson. That's complete. It's Rashad Bateman. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10.
On the run, this is J.K. Dobbins.
And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory.
Now a second and 2.
Off the play fake. Here's Jackson.
He'll swing this out to Dobbins.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. The Raven passing game getting in sync, another first down.
I like it, I like it, I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so, and gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
Jackson on first down. To the sideline and incomplete.
Then their backs up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Now a second and 10. Jackson now. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Keely Ringo picks it off. And the Eagles force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27th.
Not something you see very often from a quarterback of his caliber, an opening drive interception.
Oh, there's no doubt in my mind that even he's surprised at how that one played out. But we know this guy is not going to stop him from continuing to fire as this game goes along. Probably give a little nod of respect across the field for that one and let him know he'll be back the very next series.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 27. They'll start on the ground with Swift. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. Jadeveon Clowney there on the stop.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
On second down, Swift. And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Hurts. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
And third down is a key down in any game you play. And third down defense, something we've got to watch in this one. Got to be effective on the passing downs. That's a pretty good first step right there.
Oh, a big decision here early. Look at this. They're going to go for it on their own side of the field. They'll try and throw for it here. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And that will force a turnover on downs. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And Jackson cannot get away, and he'll go down. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Jackson's throw is on target to Likely. Down the right sideline. And he's going to be out of bounds all the way down inside the 15. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Meanwhile, Jackson's throw into the hands of Andrews. A minimal gain as we tick down inside of a minute remaining in the opening quarter.
Hey, let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on him. You're not going to be able to disguise him because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense was able to hit quickly. Anytime they think they've got him over beyond the markers, you know they're going to throw it his way, and that's not going to change even after that incompletion was forced.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and 8. Again, Jackson. And that'll be taken in by Andrews for a Ravens touchdown.
Touchdown, Baltimore.
A 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Ravens will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go.
Charles, we know that this offense is aggressive. We saw that last drive. They went for it on fourth down, didn't get it. Then they give up the touchdown. So now you feel like they really need to respond here.
They certainly do, but let's face it. Sometimes when you take that risk, you understand if you fail, a little more onus goes back on your ball club to try and pick themselves back up.
And now the throw here is incomplete. And with that, we come to the end of the first quarter of play. Here's second and 10. They will run straight ahead with Swift. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Here comes third and the length of the football. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have an Eagles first down. And he'll have it by 20 as they're able to keep the drive alive on third and inches. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. Flushed out right. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Offense was moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earned a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Throwing quickly, that's caught by Brown out wide. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. This will be caught once again by Brown. That will go as a pickup of 7 on the 7th play of the drive.
A 7-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 3 at the 8-yard line.
Swift going to try up the middle, and he'll only get a yard to bring up 3rd and 1. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down.
A gain of a yard brings up 3rd and 1.
Target. That's complete. Touchdown, Eagles. Jalen Hurts finding A.J. Brown. And the Eagles are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. Well, it was 3rd and 1. I was expecting runs, so much for that. They pass it, they score it.
That had the feel of the head coach telling the offensive coordinator, you've got 4 downs here. We're going to go for it on 4th down unless there's a disaster on 3rd. Go ahead and take a shot if you want to. And he quickly accepted the opportunity and did exactly that. If they didn't get it there, that had the feel that they would come back and try it on 4th down.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This taken in at the goal line. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
A lot of time for this unit to game plan on the sideline after that drive that they watched the other side just score. But remember, last time they were out, they scored as well. We'll see if they can seize that momentum right back.
And they have had a lot of time to cool off from reaching the end zone the last time. So have they been able to keep themselves mentally sharp and into this game, even though they haven't been on the field? And you and I both know, one big play, though, gets them right back onto that level.
They'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at 3rd down. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks.
Here's Jackson to throw. A short one there, caught by Likely. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. Nice third down conversion at even 20 yards. We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up, it's 7.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Well, this is a half for not just the coverage, but the entire defense is setting the tone in this game.
Jackson now on 2nd and 10. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
This defense is going to have to finish the job. There's still a second half that they have to play. But so far, an absolute total effort. They've disrupted the passing game, stressed the pocket for the quarterback. They forced him into errant throws. Everything they're doing has been executed well.
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Jackson. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. First down now, but that clock rolling. And Jackson throwing once more. Throw right side here, taken in by Bateman. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard. Here's Jackson. It's caught. Beckham. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 18. Jackson trying to hustle his unit up quickly to the line of scrimmage. From the red zone now, here's Jackson on first down. And in for the Ravens touchdown. Lamar Jackson hooking up with Mark Andrews. And the Ravens will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. Tucker with the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And shoves him off at the 20. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. A slim deficit here in a one-possession game. Not much time left, obviously. We'll see if they can march this down the field, at least get 3 and take some momentum into the locker room.
Hey, 73, 73. Yeah, yeah.
On 1st and 10, it's Hurts. Looking here for Smith downfield. Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. And he'll take this all the way down inside the 40.
They'll take over 1st and 10 at the 39-yard line.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. After the interception, here's Jackson. And this is going to be hauled in by the tight end Andrews. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Mark Andrews on his way to a monster game. 3 first half touchdowns. And the Ravens will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And it's now 21-7.
Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And running with power here. And able to break this out all the way to the 38-yard line. Great return.
The Eagles take over 1st and 10 at their own 38-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And with good starting field position and 3 timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together.
throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
The Hurts going to move him around.
On second and 10, Hurts. Crossing route, and he finds Swift. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. So the ball moves from 1:38 to the other as they come up on first and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. Going deep here for Watkins. Touchdown! Chris Watkins in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Elliott Good with a PAT. And they're back within a touchdown at 21-14. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Darius Slay with a pick. And a potential turning point as they get the football in very good field position late in this first half.
Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there. You throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
So we've reached halftime here in a 4-point game as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter 3? He will return this from deep in the end zone. Oh, a good looking return set up here. He's past the 30. He will score. Touchdown, Eagles.
We've sat in a lot of meetings and they always talk about the offense taking advantage of beginning a half. Because special teams coaches don't listen to that. They want to take advantage with their own unit, and they just did.
Yeah, they trailed in the locker rooms, and they changed that immediately.
I think they drew that one up special. That felt like something he pulled out of his pocket that he'd been holding for a while, and he was able to use it effectively.
Elliott Good on the extra point, and that gives him a 3-point lead. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Next drive, and they find themselves down on the scoreboard following the field goal a moment ago.
And I think even though they trail in the game now, I would consider that a win for their defense, and that's probably what they're telling the offense when they get to the bench. Hey, the onus is on you guys now. Get back out there and get us the lead back.
Well, they'll certainly be on the tablets going over that one for sure. Clearly, they were expecting something else out of the defense and couldn't adjust to make that completion happen.
Now Jackson. He completes it to Beckham. Now they work this well upfield across the 45. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Jackson on first down. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
So much of his game is focus and concentration. And whenever I see guys running the in route, I know that in the back of their mind, they're always wondering who's lurking inside that might put a big hit on them as they try and catch the ball.
Second and 10. Jackson will throw again. Crossing the field, Beckham makes a catch. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 29-yard line. Jackson. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. And the Eagles will take over here at their own 14-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all of our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Yeah, points certainly not at a premium here. But first down, Hurts. And that's going to be caught downfield by Brown. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
As they began this drive, I was wondering how they were going to attack since they're playing with the lead. Would they continue to try and push the ball downfield? Well, after one play, it appears that the answer is yes.
On first and 10, it's Swift. He'll get this up to about the 44.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
From the 44-yard line, here's second and 6. On the option to give to Swift here. And some solid footwork there as he'll take this down to about the 38. 52 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries. Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past them.
They'll get that one out quickly to Brown. Down the left sideline. Touchdown! A.J. Brown, his second touchdown of the night, and the Eagles are able to stretch out their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Elliott good with a PAT, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. Touchdown. Here's Elliott on to kick it away. Duvernay going to sit on this in the end zone, so it'll come out to the 25. Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And
frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long.
I really like the angles that the tacklers came from on that play. They secured inside, took away the cutback. The sideline's there, so you can only go so far outside, and they were able to close in and tackle him for a loss.
Yeah, they use your boy over there, the 12th man, Sammy Sideline, right?
Sammy Sideline. You know something? He tackles pretty well, too.
He's tougher than an airport stick.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
To throw again is Jackson. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They'll throw on first down with Jackson. Over the middle, and there's a diving catch. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. Over the middle to Beckham. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. Here's Jackson to throw. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down.
In the early days of the NFL, you could easily blame these drops on maybe some uneven or uncertain lighting in the stadium. Not anymore. The lights are pretty good.
Yeah, they're great here at night, but his second drop indeed. Not a good look. Again, Jackson. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
Well, how about the coverage we just saw break out on third down? Dime defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. Jackson now. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by James Bradbury. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race.
Silver tooth and I was just a pup, yeah. Now I got some killers who got shotties with the pups. I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. Got a shorty clean the penis, I'm a diamond and the run it back. Used to have a silver tooth but I was just a pup. Now I got some killers who got shotties with the pups. I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. I let shorty clean the penis, I'm a diamond and the run. First order of biz, no snitch. And I try to keep it silent but the kids don't listen. The earth egg, got another hit, no flinch. And I tell them send a watch that I can fit both friends. So she on the class trying to get a nigga. She think I'm a last cause I got a pass with her. And I ain't trying to let her down but I'm not. If you was trying to settle down, get a fact. So I'm pull up in the city with a nice jump. Lights off, lights on. Chinese throw the chicken, need a wipe to throw the rice on. Pull up double park with all the ice on. Pick them like, she running up, she running up. Bills, she did up. 52nd Street, I doubled down, then I doubled up. 2023, and I'm the only